everyone, I'm F4H Racerz and welcome back to finally yet another YouTube video. And today you join me at the Forza Mini Challenge round 5 or so, I think it's round 5. But either way, we're at the Silverstone International Circuit, and it's one of my favourite, probably the favourite track of mine on the calendar, so I'm looking forward to this race. As you just saw, I'm starting P6 for race 1. And it'll be interesting to see what we can salvage from this race. So if you didn't know, I am currently leading the championship of this series, so hopefully I'll be able to get high up on the grid and salvage some points that I greatly need in order to stay comfortable up at the front. So here we go then, 3, 2, 1, and away we go. 6th on the grid, as I mentioned. We've got a good start, actually. The front wheel drive of this Mini pulling us away off the line pretty good. The rear tyres, though, into turn 1 will be cold, and as you can see, everyone's sliding about quite a lot, me included. Bam Renault gets up onto that curb and gets a huge slide, and now Commando and Renault have formed a sandwich. They are the bread, I am the filling, and somehow I've gone through the middle of both of them into turn 1. So what a beginning to the start of the race, race-wise rather than commentary-wise, because what I was saying about sandwiches was just frankly questionable. But yeah, so we skip on lap 2 when we catch up to GTR Yoda now, and we're chasing him down, wanting to get the position off of him, get onto the podium, so then we can chase down the guys on in first and second. As you can see though, into the braking zone, I do have a bit of an issue with the brakes. I didn't really want to lock up and pressure was high, defending from Ban Renault, you know, having to be as defensive as I could without just straight up just hitting him off. But unfortunately, because of my defensive line, he's now got a good run on us, as you can see in the bottom corner of the screen. He's just catching up, so I'm going to just force him really, really close to the inside. But he's there, there's nothing I can do about that. So down into fourth gear, I'm going to try and hang it around the outside. I've got to make sure I can get the exit here, because if he gets more of an exit than me, he will easily get me into the next corner. But luckily my exit was brilliant, and I'm going to almost guaranteed stay ahead here because I've got the defensive line into this section of corners. And now I can really just focus on catching up to Yoda again. I'm not going to be as aggressive as I was the lap before. Going on to lap 4 now, right on Yoda's tail, we've actually gapped Renault pretty comfortably now. We've got 200 feet over him. Yoda though, getting up onto the grass, it's not looking too strong. His line through there wasn't the best. So down into third, I'm right on his tail now. I'm going to try and put on the pressure as much as I can. Not do a stupid move in here though, because that's what I did last time and it clearly didn't work. So on this corner here though, I'm sure you saw that I broke, braked quite a lot to try and get the exit, and it didn't really work. But Yoda managed to hit some tyres that for some reason are there. I don't know why turn 10 would put that tyre wall there, but feinting to the inside into Stowe. By the looks of it, the pressure or something was too much, as he's managed to get two wheels onto the grass, and that's ruined his drive-through Stowe. And I'm now into third, but he's still there on the inside, so I'm going to brake really, really late and just cut off his line really, really tight there. It was, I had to be careful with that, because I could have just swiped into him and completely totaled him, but I didn't, and I managed to judge it quite well. So now we're in third, we're cruising, and I've just got to see if I can gap Yoda and catch up to the cars ahead. But you will see it's lap 5 and JSR Type R and Yoda are both deciding to pit, leaving myself and JSR hysterical to lap as we will and try to gain an advantage over the other cars. So you join us lap 11 now, and we've managed to keep the gap to hysterical pretty nicely. I think the closest I got to him was 250 feet over the course of about lap 5 to lap 11, so it's pretty good to keep with him because he is extremely quick. Ideally though, I would have wanted to catch up to him for the win, but I'll settle for my current position this once. But pitting now, lap 11, and on pit exit we've just got to see where we come out relative to JSR Type R, who is currently the leader of the on-track cars. So he was well in front of me, as you saw when we started to pit, so it'll be interesting to see where he is. So as we look back, there he is actually, and we're going to be able to get the jump on him if we go very defensive extremely quickly, and we have. And as you can see, he's on the inside going into turn three. So I'm going to shift down three times, and I've managed to hold it around the outside on cold tyres. So that's great news for me. I think he wasn't quite aggressive enough. And obviously I was as aggressive as you can be on cold tyres, I guess, because it's so difficult to hold your position when you haven't got any tyre temperature. But that's ultimately a very, very good success for us, as we've now managed to get into second place overall, and I've only got a few more corners to hold him off for, so this is awesome news coming into Stowe. And so hitting the apex, well, we kind of missed it a bit, but on the exit we get nicely up onto the curb, but Ty Barr is imminently going to go for a dive, so I decide to go defensive and park it on the apex at all costs. But I managed actually to get an awesome exit, and I've actually managed to pull, if you look at the, you know, the feet distance between us, I managed to actually get a better exit than him, even though I went defensive. So that was awesome news. P2 in race one. I couldn't have asked for any more. So let's move on to race two now, see if I can continue on this form. This race I'll be starting one better, P5, and it's no less competitive of a grid, of course, because it's the same grid. But JSR Type R ahead, 3, 2, 1, and off we go at the Silverstone International Mini Challenge Race 2. And so the cars ahead, they all get good starts, of course, and I'm just going to try and focus on getting turn 1 as perfect as possible. Maybe I can, you know, do what I did in Race 1 and try and overtake some people into the first corner. So going into turn 3, braking nice and cautiously, we've got TX3 Wizard on the outside. I think he wanted to try and capitalise on us going a bit slowly, a bit cautious, but as you can see, there's three cars very slow on the inside, and I go for a dive and probably definitely time it a tad too late, tag Commando, and that's not helped either of us, as now I've got Hysterical and Wizard either side of me. In fact, no, we're four wide, I think. That's another car. Didn't quite see who that was, but we're going four wide at the moment. And Hysterical's come out best. He's up to fifth. I'm down to sixth. Wizard hasn't managed to get any positions, but it's not over yet. We're still, you know, very, very grouped up together. And Wizard now tagging me, and I get a bit of a slide on. Yoda nearly killed me on the inside. That was hard in mouth moment for me. And now Commando has gone wide through this final section of the lap, and that's allowed me back up into P5, but unfortunately I've let Hysterical into fourth, and that's not good by any stretch of its meaning. So skipping onto lap four, Hysterical and Type R still battling. We've managed to catch right up to the back of them, but Type R hits the inside curb at Abbey, and now I'm able to attack. I've managed to take Type R, and I'm going to go for Hysterical on the outside, so I'm going to try and hang it out to dry. And unfortunately Hysterical has managed to defend from me pretty nicely, and now I think he's going to try and let Type R up the inside. So Type R brakes nice and late, tries to get the exit, but he hasn't managed to get the exit out of this right hander, and somehow I've actually managed to come out with a pretty decent drive out of there. So I'll be looking to overtaking Hysterical into Stowe. So he goes defensive, as you can see. So I'm going to move to the inside, try and scare him into going as close to the inside as possible to ruin his exit. And then as soon as he commits, I'll go back to the outside to try and get my awesome drive, which you can see I've got now. So feint into the outside to move him out there, and then feint into the inside again. On the brakes, though, it all goes horribly wrong. I think if you rewind that and watch back at the little telemetry, you'll see the brake pedal effectively goes absolutely mental. And I think that's just nerves for you. Don't feel it that often, but on the brakes, I don't know, it just had a finger spasm or something. So yeah, so going into the pits, I want to try and reset. And as I come out of the pits once again on lap 6, you can see that Nenzi is actually very close, and he's managed to just bombard round our outside. It's definitely not, you know, very aggressive, but you know, fair enough to him, he's managed to take the position. I was on cold tyres anyway. And now this isn't good, because I know that I'm a lot faster than Nenzi. He's a quick guy, but he's not front runner pace at the moment in this race. Is behind Wizard, absolutely totals himself in that wall. So I'm going to try and overtake Nenzi into Stowe, try and minimise the effect that I'll have, you know, stuck behind him. So feinting, you know, you'll probably see this in a lot of my videos, especially in these smaller cars like these minis. I like to try and dart around, try and play mind games on the car that I'm attacking, really try and put the try and control where their car goes, because I can really read the situation. If I, you know, I can picture where their car would be and where it would be favourable for me personally, as we actually go for a switchback there and get it a bit wrong, and then there's a bit of contact, and now Nenzi's managed to get the drive on us, approaching lap 7, going into turn 1 now, and as you can see, Type R has actually pitted to try and cover us, understandably. But he doesn't actually need to cover us at all, because I've lost so much time behind Nenzi that he's pulled quite a significant gap. And considering the fact that we were actually ahead of him, at this point I was a bit annoyed, because, you know, it was all that mistake on the brakes with Hysterical. If I hadn't done that, I would be easily sort of on for a podium in this race. But so it just proves how little margin for error we do have in this league, as I finally get the drive over Nenzi, and this looks like it'll be my position as we overtake his multicoloured, tropical looking Mini Cooper. Beyond the brakes, it makes it pretty easy for us now, hitting the apex nicely, trying to get the exit. And now we've just got to think about chasing down Type R, although, you know, we know that he's quick. We need him to hit traffic if we're gonna be able to overtake him, but it just doesn't look like it's gonna happen at the moment. So coming on to lap 8, GTI Yoda, he was just behind us when we pitted, and he's now just in front of us, so I'm gonna have to be as aggressive as possible. So I brake ultra late into turn 1. I'm gonna do what Type R didn't do and try and get round the car with cold tires, and I've managed to go around his outside there, which was absolutely brilliant. If Type R had done that to me in race 1, I would have been absolutely toast. So I'm pretty glad that I could make that move stick. But yeah, skipping on lap 11, since then Bam Renault has pitted and come out of the pits just ahead of us, so he's done a stellar job to get out in front of us, because he was quite the, you know, I haven't actually seen him this whole race, so it proves either how good he is or how bad we've been in this race. But yeah, I've got one lap now to try and dispose of Renault. It's not easy, we know how fast he is. So actually, I've been battling with Type R and Renault before, and who's this? Oh, none other than JSR Rossi has left the pit, so another absolutely insane driver to try and get in the mix. So he's going to try to defend for his life up against Renault. So I can see an opportunity here. I can see a move up the inside, but Renault actually, he manages to cover it off brilliantly, and that allows Rossi for the switch back on us. And now we're just in the passenger seat going up the hangar straight on the final lap. There's not a lot we can really do now. The odds are definitely in Rossi's favour here for the the prize position of P5. So as Rossi goes tacking into Stowe, he manages to get the position, and once again he looks in the strong area of the track to try and get the drive over Renault. But will Renault give up though? That's the question. No, he won't. We know he won't, because, you know, Renault is one of the more aggressive drivers, very controlled but aggressive. But that allows us on the inside of both cars for their double overtake, and that gets us into P5. So that was our sort of get out of jail free card. What a move. I was really happy with that. But yeah, that was brilliant stuff. So now on to race 3, where I'm going to try and continue on this good form. A bit higher than 5th would be better though. Here we are then, race 3, and the grid ordering is reverse results of race 1. So obviously we came 2nd, which means we're all the way back here in 11th. So it'll be interesting to see what we can do. Only Hysterical is behind us. But as the lights prepare to go green, which they have now, we've just got to try and follow the likes of JSR Type R and BAM A6 ahead, and see if we can sort of capitalise on any mistakes from anyone else. And hopefully we'll be able to get a good point scoring position out of this round, because, you know, race 2, 5th position, it was alright, but not to the standard that I want. You know, I want podiums every race if I can, but into turn 1 it's an absolute mess. We've got Hysterical on our outside, who gave us a bit of a tap, and that sort of sent us drifting into the middle of the track, and now we're sort of squeezing our way around, being bounced around like sort of in a bumper car, as now Type R has managed to get the run on us up on the inside, and Hysterical looks like he's going to get us as well. And now look at that, F4H Racerz all the way down in P12 of 12. We're in last position. Not something I ever like to, you know, ever like to say or see for that matter. But you know, to be fair, we started second last, so it's not all over yet. It's not like I should just go and park up my car right now because I'm in last. There's definitely points and positions that I can salvage from this position as Yoda is hit wide. I think that was by hysterical into this final section of the lap, and now I've just got to try and get past Yoda as fast as I can. He's an extremely quick driver over one lap, but he's known, I think he's more likely to make a mistake than some other drivers, let's say, but no disrespect to his pace, as he's an incredibly quick driver. As we come into turn three anyway, on the brakes, nice and calm, I don't want to cause any accidents, and we sort of rub up against the back of Yoda's Mini, and as you can see though, it's just so many cars as I dive up the inside and tap hysterical, tap Yoda. And at the time I actually thought that was really dirty, I'm not going to lie, I thought I really, really made a big mistake there, so I eased off and let Yoda back through. And now I look at it, I really shouldn't have. I do think that that was actually a valid move to make, especially in these front wheel drive Minis. I didn't harm Yoda's sort of run enough, and I did get alongside him like I should have done if I was going to go for a move like that. But yeah, as we can see up ahead, bam, A6 going for, I think that's an illegal pit, but we'll sort of gloss over that, pretend I didn't see. As Yoda now goes wide, and I think that's going to allow us all the way up into P10, so we're going to go from last to P10 in this final corner effectively, because A6 pits, and now look at that hit from hysterical pitting on lap 3. he left that quite late, didn't he? It's the groundskeepers of Silverstone are going to have an easy job that day. But yeah, so we're continuing on our pace, we're lapping really well. As you can see, it's only lap 4 and we're already got about 550 feet to Yoda, and as Veeps and Rossi as well as Type R are pitting, so yeah, we now skip on all the way to lap 10, and you'll see that we are just completely alone lapping lap after lap after lap. And as you can see up at the top right, we're ultra consistent, ultra quick at the moment, just almost identical times just there, and anything lower than a 11.3 is rapid, like properly quick. I know that all three of those laps that you just saw, I believe, were faster than my qualifying time, but as we skip on, we've made our first of the two pit stops we have to make, and Bam Renault is still well ahead of us, but we've actually managed to get the jump on JSR Hysterical, so that's good. But I know I'm on cold tires, I know I am going to lose out if I, you know, stay in front of him, and I don't like driving under pressure from him either, because he is quick and I don't really want to have to defend, so I just come straight back in the pits. I don't want any of that, to be honest. I just want to get out of there. And so that's exactly what I do. So I pit, and here we are again, exiting the pits. We've made both our pit stops now. Bam A6 is behind. We've managed to jump in, and we've just got to try and hold our position now. So if we can make the braking, you know, into the turn warner, turn three even, that's all gone wrong there in terms of the comm, but yeah, so we managed to brake well. We've kept A6 behind, and up ahead, Hysterical, Renault and Rossi have all pitted, as it's the final lap that they can pit, of course. We're currently the lead car on track, so this is really good news. Considering we were last place, to now be running in fourth is awesome, to say the least, because, you know, it's never easy to get a podium in this, but to get it from last position on the grid shows what sort of pace we've got at the moment. So I'm having to defend like mad though, saying that from A6, he obviously wants this position. I'm not going to give it to him though, although he can earn it if he feels he can. But anyway, as we approach the turn one of the final lap, we're going to watch and see where all the cars exit the pits from, and as you can see, two of them are definitely well ahead, and we're going to come up right next to Hysterical, so I go straight defensive, don't want to let him through. But on the brakes, as you can see, I was really struggling with this on the brakes in high pressure situations. I just felt like I sort of lost the slighter touch you need on the brakes, but still managed to get P3, which is awesome. And now I've just got to try and hold it for the rest of this lap, and then I will have scored a podium position, even though I was last on lap 2, and I started, you know, second last on the grid. We've managed to keep Hysterical behind us, who did start right at the back on the grid. But yeah, this is looking like a really strong result for us now. If we can finish third, we will equal our top points scoring round, which actually is currently Road Atlanta from last week, where I scored 58 points. But this will equal that, I do believe, if my calculations are quick in my head. And quick and correct, of course. But yeah, that's lap 15 of 15. We are P3 of 12. As you can see, JSR Rossi's going for a bit of a roll there. That's quite a good spin. But overall, that's been an awesome round, an awesome set of races, some great racing. And if you've got this far, I massively appreciate your support. Seriously, you know, to watch a video for this long shows that you must have enjoyed it at the very least. But yeah, so if you could leave a like rating, that would be awesome. Also, follow me on Twitter. That's always appreciated. But apart from that, guys, thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you next time.